Good evening, everyone. Iowa traded unemployment offices for computer kiosks to help the jobless, saving the state millions of dollars.
A new report questions just how well those kiosks are working. News Channel 8's Noelle Smith has our top story. Noelle?
These computer kiosks have been controversial since they were put in last November, and this new report says they could use some improvement.
Why did that go away? It's harder looking for a job than it is working one.
Ruth McDowell has been an unemployed registered nurse for 3 years, and now she's given up looking.
You're sitting there, and none of it makes sense. And you're frustrated anyway because you're unemployed and you're trying to find jobs and openings and you're going through this whole thing and your morale starts going down.
She's used these computer kiosks called virtual access points to look for a job and is unimpressed. A preliminary report from the U.S. Department of Labor has found some issues with the system, like a lack of oversight and feedback.
And we're always taking the feedback that we get. We have a feedback that we receive in multiple ways. We have a pop-up survey.
But Winterset Public Librarian Tanya Porter says she's seen other issues too.
It said click here for a resume and it would take her off to somewhere else.
She says it's clunky and the bulk of the people she tries to help struggle with computer literacy and she's only been given this small binder as a guide.
I try to help the best I can because, geez, we're the only place that in this area.
Obviously, the computer systems are not perfect for everybody, which is why
Iowa Workforce Development spokeswoman Carrie Kuntz stands behind the system. She says some of the findings in the report are wrong and were not identified in the final meeting with the U.S. Department of Labor.
They didn't mention any of those problems to us about the access points. So somewhere in their reporting from when they were here to what they told us to what they presented in the report is inaccurate.
Kuhn says they're making a plan to fix some of the things the federal government wants fixed, but they're also be questioning those things they believe the Department of Labor got wrong.
All right, Noelle Smith with our lead story. Thank you.